What do
coffee
and AI have in common? Well, a few years ago, grabbing coffee and working out were simple. You'd order a regular coffee, you'd maybe hit the treadmill, and you'd call it a day. Well, now you walk into a cafe and you see oat milk lattes, cold brews, nitro shots, and at the gym, it's HIIT classes, macro training, and intermittent fasting. Well, the fundamentals of AI remain the same. Build models and solve problems. But the terminology has expanded, and now staying updated is key for developers and practitioners. AI is really going through this same transformation. Now, those simple words like robots and automation have expanded, and you hear terms like machine learning, deep learning, and LLMs. So today, we're going to decode that language so you can stay in the game, because AI, it's all around us. Now, let's start with the foundation. The three big topics of AI. Our first subset of AI is machine learning. And machine learning means teaching computers to learn patterns from data instead of hard coding rules. An example, machine learning powers recommendation systems, identifying patterns in user behavior to suggest the most relevant content. Now, a type of machine learning is deep learning. And deep learning, it's a subset that uses artificial neural networks. So that's different layers of nodes that mimic how our brains process information to learn patterns from large amounts of data, common theme, and it can handle huge data sets and learn very complex relationships. Deep learning powers things like image recognition and even games beating world champions. Now, another type of AI is natural language processing. And NLP is another acronym that you'll hear commonly used for natural language processing. It helps AI understand and generate human language. So think about generative AI, or voice assistants answering questions, or even translation tools. So NLP uses algorithms and models to break down sentences into different parts and to understand the meaning and to generate those responses. Now let's go deeper into the building blocks. First, we have algorithms versus models. So algorithms are the recipes, while models are the finished dish. Algorithms are the step-by-step instructions, just like step-by-step to bake a cake. And the model is that cake, that trained system created by applying an algorithm to data, which is our second topic. Data is the fuel. So big data means massive data sets, but beware of bias. Bias can skew your results, and it can exist in your data. And finally, we have training, validation, and testing. And you can think of it as practice, midterms, and finals for AI models. Let's take a peek into what's coming next and the innovations shaping tomorrow's AI. We have generative AI, a very widely known term today, and that's actually AI that's creating new content. So things like images, text, or even code. Generative AI enables this creation, enhancing workflows across domains. Imagine designing something like a logo or writing a song with even just a prompt That's the power of generative AI. We also have reinforcement learning. In reinforcement learning, it's a type of machine learning, and it's AI that learns by trial and error. So this repetitive process. It's like teaching a robot to walk or an AI agent to complete a task. Instead of being told what to do, the agent or robot figures it out by trying different actions and learning what leads to good outcomes and what leads to bad outcomes. And finally, we have explainable AI. And explainable AI, it helps us to understand why AI makes a decision, and that transparency truly matters. So how do you keep up? Well, you can follow trusted sources, you can take courses, and you can experiment and try things out for yourself responsibly. AI is powerful, but it's up to us to use it wisely.